The Philippines will field more than 800 athletes to the 32nd Southeast Asian Games in Phnom Penh, Cambodia. Joyce Balancho is on the line with more details on the athletes' send-off ceremony. Joyce?
Yes, Denise. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Monday afternoon led the send-off ceremony for the Filipino athletes who would be participating in the 32nd Southeast Asian Games happening at Phnom Penh in Cambodia on May 5 to 17, 2023. 860 athletes will compete in 608 events covering 38 different sports. Hailing them as the country's ambassadors in sports, the president assured the Filipino athletes that the government will provide all the support that they need to make them successful in their chosen sport. Marcos Jr. also highlighted the benefits of engaging in sports, especially for the youth, noting that it promotes discipline, good health, camaraderie, teamwork, among others. With this, the president also assured support to the Philippine Sports Commission and the Philippine Olympic Committee, who have been at the forefront of developing young athletes who would soon bring home medals for the country. With all the hard trainings and preparations for the SEA Games, the president is optimistic that the country will break its record of wins. In 2021 at Hanoi, Vietnam, the Philippines ranked fourth among the participating SEA Games countries, garnering 52 gold medals, 70 silver medals, and 105 bronze medals. Marcos Jr. thanked all the athletes in the past for bringing honor and glory to the country and also challenged the new set of athletes to give their best in their chosen events. Under Republic Act No. 10699 or the National Athletes and Coaches Benefits and Incentives Act, a Filipino athlete who secures a gold medal from the SEA Games will receive 300,000 pesos as cash bonus, while the silver medalist and the bronze medalist will get 150,000 and 60,000 pesos respectively. Denise?
Thanks, Joyce.
A trainer aircraft crashes in the province of Batangas. The Philippine Air Force said the Marchetti aircraft encountered problems at the upwind of the Fernando Air Base in Lipa City. The two pilots were able to maneuver the plane into an open area, causing no damage to nearby communities. Both pilots are safe and undergoing treatment. The Air Force said an investigation is underway. The Philippine government maintains its economic growth forecast between 6 and 7% this year. But as Jackie Pascual tells us, it also expects a higher inflation for 2023.
The Philippine economic team has raised its inflation assumption for 2023 at the development budget quoting to recover following the pandemic. Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno also mentioned that revenue projections in the medium term are expected to improve from 3.73 trillion pesos in 2023 to 6.62 trillion pesos in 2028. These are because of proposed tax measures like VAT on digital service providers, excise taxes on single-use plastics and pre-mixed alcohol, and there are also proposed additional excise taxes on sweetened beverages, which are expected to hit 53.7 billion in revenues in the first year. Motor vehicle road users tax will possibly also add 15.8 billion pesos in revenues for the first year, and the mining fiscal regime tax could also add 12.4 billion pesos by 2025. Meanwhile, prices of Dubai crude oil are also expected to go down this year, and the peso-dollar exchange rate were adjusted downwards to 53 to 57 pesos.